Following President Museveni's recent visit to South Africa, the senior presidential advisor on special duties, Odrek Rabogo, has decided to meet the Ugandan exporters to take them through the new opportunities that emerged from the president's visit that they can tap into. According to Rabogo, during this visit, they found some companies in South Africa which are willing to buy Ugandan goods, especially the perishable products like fruits and vegetables. He noted that what is needed at the moment are reliable suppliers. Therefore, Ugandan exporters should take advantage of this market.
Question number one, which was, would we find buyers? Yes, we found some companies. I can name a few. Blantons for fruits, juices, vegetables. I won't tell you the name of the person. It will take you a lot of time. We sat with this company and others, and they said, can we exploit the East African market? Can you tell us whether you have enough farmers to grow these fruits? Can we keep fresh vegetables from the market straight to customers? Can you tell us commercial incentives that we require? So there are companies we found.
In this meeting, he also noted that they are considering lowering the cost of trade, a move which has started with Uganda Airlines cutting the cost of transporting perishable goods to South Africa. A 50% reduction has been registered, and all perishable goods can now be transported at $1.
In vegetables, if you're in fruits, so this fellow who was asking for a tax rebate, the gentleman in South Africa, I will tell you, the one who was exhibiting pineapples, now he has no ruekwaso. At least we can do this at $1. Thank you, Uganda Airlines. I'm glad we keep pursuing. So what we're trying to add more options.
Authorities don't make demands for this paperwork from us as an airline. From passengers, we shall not demand for those items. But the onus is on the ministry, to enforce guidelines and requirements to conform with the requirements for export of perishable fruits and vegetables out of our market.
The High Commissioner of Uganda to South Africa, Paul Amoru, commended Ugandan traders for eyeing the South African market.
We're now having many serious Ugandan businesses entering South Africa, but in the past we had a few challenges with what some of our people were doing there. You heard about the Sangomas and all of that. The president talked about it, and many cases when I appear for this meeting, I'm being asked to present the list of Ugandan businesses that are in South Africa. So we also want to have this database at the embassy.
Amoru, however, challenged the Ugandan exporters to be very organized as they get to South Africa, committing that as an embassy, they are willing to give them a hand.
Intentional, we are deliberate, and we don't want to do things as usual. The chairman, Notrek, has already said usual is very dangerous. Now, many issues have already been raised, and Chairman Odrek has eloquently given the helicopter view of the key objectives that took us to South Africa, especially in the area of business, the business summit.
Uganda is South Africa's 15th largest trading partner in Africa and the second largest in East Africa, according to the South African government figures. Between 2017 and 2021, total trade between the two countries reached a peak of $162 million. South Africa's exports to Uganda amounted to $169 million in 2018, while its imports from Uganda increased from $6.8 million in 2017 to $17.5 million in 2020. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.